Hello watcher and subscribers, now here we will see how you can use multiple condition in scratch programming. In the last tutorial we use if and if else, but in the limitation of if and if else we can have only one condition, but now we will use multiple if, and then you will understand how we can have multiple condition in the scratch programming or any other programming. Because whatever you are learning, whatever the logic you are learning here, it will be used in other programming also. So it's very important. Now here in the event category I just add the flag. So this is the flag. When I click on the flag, output will be generated. And in the control category I would like to add three if statement. This is one, this is two, this is third. Okay, so this is our structure of the program. So along with that we will learn one more thing. That thing is that we will see how you can add ask and answer block from the sensing category. So that use also you will understand. First I am going to ask, and here the statement is, so here our statement is what is the number. So ask, okay, means what happened exactly when I click on this flag, then this statement is generated, what is the number. So this statement is nothing but input statement, because by using the sprite we are getting the input value here. Because in any programming language there are three stages: input, process and output. Input means the value is taking from the user, means we provide some value to our program, and process means calculation, addition, subtraction, multiplication, whatever it is, and output means it is showing the result. Okay, so here the input is, means we are taking some values, and that value we will be providing to that program. So here after this ask we have to use answer, but before using answer, in the operator category I am using condition, because the if statement must have the condition. So we need back to back three condition, and here I am using answer. We have to use answer there. Here it's answer block in the sensing category. So I need three answer here because we have three condition. Now here you will understand the use of answer. What happened here, once I run the program, whatever the values are there you can provide here, and you just click on this right. So that value will send to answer. So here answer is taking the values. Okay, it is just working as a, you can say, memory or variable you can say. So it is just taking the value. So here whatever the input we are providing, that will be stored in the answer. Okay, so here if the answer is whatever the value, but here nothing is happening because we don't have coding inside the block. So here in the looks category, through this looks category I am adding some statement. Same for second if statement. Okay, so here first condition is answer greater than 50. Suppose my second condition is greater than 40 and third one is greater than 10. These are the three condition. So here I have to write statement number is, so here the statement is number is greater than 50. Okay, because we use condition answer greater than 50. So I just copy this statement and paste it here for saving my time. I also paste in the third if. So here it is greater than 40. So here I am writing greater than 40. In place of 50, I have to write 40. Then in the third one, I have to write 10. So here you observe now. Now here I will explain you how it is working. Suppose we click on the flag. So we have to take input here. Suppose our input is 66. Once I click on the right, what you think, what will happen? 66 is greater than 50, it is true. So whatever we are writing inside the if, it will show. Second also, it is also greater than 40, it is also greater than 10. So it will show all these three if statement output. We will check it out. It is greater than 50, nice. It is greater than 40, nice. And it is greater than 10. Because what happened, that value whichever we enter, that is greater than 50, it is satisfying all the three classes, because that value is greater than 50, greater than 40, greater than 10. So it is showing all these three condition. Now here we have, suppose value 44. So suppose our value is 44. So 44 greater than 50, it is false. So here second one, it is true, because 44 is greater than 40. Here also it is true. So we just check it out. Second one is running, and third one, because the 44 was greater than 40 and 10. So we were getting this two output, number is greater than 40 and greater than 10. Now once again, now here I am putting smaller value 12. So once you do that, then 12 not greater than 50, not greater than 50. So it is only greater than 10. So we will get the output from third one. So you see greater than 10. And suppose again I am running and I am putting the value 5. So nothing will work now. You see, you are not getting any output. So now I just explain this. When you click on the flag, ask means take the input value. And by using the ask, we can show, we can take the value, and that value will go to answer. So ask statement, by using the ask statement, we can provide the input, and that input will go to the answer. So here answer will hold that input value, and then we can check it out result. So here this condition is true, then if is executed. So here suppose all these three condition true, then we will get the output from all the three block. If only one is true, then we will get the output from only one block. So in this way, multiple conditions you can use in the Scratch programming. So once you understood this concept, you can use this in any other programming language. So I hope, dear student, you understood the concept of multiple if statement. Thanks for watching this. Thank you.